Pemphigoid, herpes, gestationes. It is a vesiculobullous disease that is usually seen in the last trimester of pregnancy, although it can be seen in the second trimester or may develop postpartum. Sometimes it is associated with hydatidiform moles, very pruritic papules and urticarial plaques, which evolve to form vesicles and bullae develop initially in a periumbilical distribution with spread to the rest of the trunk and extremities. The dermis shows a mixed infiltrate including neutrophils and eosinophils. There is usually formation of subepidermal vesicles and bullae which sometimes may appear to be located intraepidermally due to the orientation of the tissue. The bullae contain eosinophils, lymphocytes and histiocytes. Direct immunofluorescence shows deposition of C3 and sometimes Ig in a linear pattern along the basal membrane. The immunoglobulins are located in the lamina lucida and on anchoring filaments similar to bullous pemphigoid. A circulating autoantibody of the Ig class, the so-called pemphigoid gestationis factor, can be found in the majority of patients with pemphigoid gestationis. Other subepidermal bullous processes include diabetic bullae manifests as tense bulla on the lower extremities of patients with diabetes mellitus without renal failure. Histologically, the bullae are non-inflammatory, subepidermal and sometimes intraepidermal. Amyloid bullae non-inflammatory, subepidermal bullae may be seen sometimes in amyloidosis. The surrounding dermis shows deposition of amyloid erythema. Multiform, bullous, shows subepidermal bullae formed by pronounced edema of the papillary dermis, which also contains fibrin and inflammatory cells. Other changes of erythema multiform are seen around and within the bulla. Toxic epidermal necrolysis shows full thickness necrosis of the epidermis, which is detached from the dermis, with formation of a bullae or an empty space. Non-inflammatory bullous lupus erythematosus characterized by the presence of neutrophils and nuclear dust at the dermal-epidermal junction with separation of the epidermis from the dermis. Otherwise, changes of systemic lupus erythematosus are seen particularly around hair follicles and other adnexae. Lichen planus sometimes exhibits cleavage between the epidermis and the dermis, the so-called Max Joseph spaces, in an otherwise typical lichen planus picture. Full separation of the epidermis may be seen. Pressure and coma-induced bullae are usually subepidermal, although the epidermis may have spongiosis, which may result also in intraepidermal vesicles. When the bulla is associated with barbiturate intake, there is necrosis of acrine coils and ducts, which is diagnostic for this entity.